This week's video was sparked from a question I received on my Facebook business page from Tommy. Tommy is relatively new to airbrushing. He bought an airbrush from Harbor Freight just to make sure this is something he's going to want to stick with before he actually upgrades. He had a couple questions. He wants to start out by painting tumblers and car tags. So his questions were, do I need to spray any kind of sealer on them first before applying paint? And do they need to be sealed after the paint has been applied? So let's dive in. Before I answer Tommy's two specific questions, I wanted to touch on the idea of buying a less expensive, either no name or off-brand airbrush, especially when you're brand new to all this and just learning. I get it. I completely understand the logic behind not wanting to invest a lot of money into a hobby that you may or may not even enjoy by the time it's all said and done. That makes perfect sense. I also understand we're all under different financial situations. We can't always afford to just go buy whatever we want, especially when it comes to a hobby. What I would caution you against when it comes to buying those less expensive alternatives is the fact that the quality and the precision when it comes to manufacturing those products is likely not going to be comparable to the better known name brand versions. I've tried just about every airbrush that's available out there as far as the well-known name brands go. I've never tried any of the knockoff, no name, alternative airbrushes for those reasons. So I get that you don't want to invest a lot of money up front, but the downside is if the quality and the precision in those products is not on par, that could lead to frustration when you're trying to learn. If your equipment is not working correctly or if it's a little bit off, that could lead to frustration. I hope that makes sense. So I'm not saying they're all bad. Again, I've never tried any of them, but it's just something to think about, especially if you're thinking about getting into airbrushing or wanting to get into airbrushing and you're looking at those cheaper alternatives. Moving on to answer Tommy's two questions, beginning with the sealer question. Do you need to apply a sealer either to your license plate tag blank or to a tumbler before you begin painting your design onto either one of those items? To answer that question, kind of need to understand why we have sealers to begin with. Sealers are designed to give you a uniform color to begin working over. So if you have done any repair work, maybe you have a small little dent or ding that you had to repair with some filler, and then you've got primer over that. So you may have more than one color on the surface before you start actually painting. Similar to this aluminum panel I have on the backboard of my easel now. At one point I had sprayed a blue base coat onto this panel, and then at some point I came in and sanded that blue base coat down to do something else with this panel. And you can see that I have sanded through the blue base coat in several areas, the most notable being this circular section right here where you can actually see the white underlying powder coat. If I was to come in, let's say I wanted to start this panel with a white color. So I wanted the entire panel just to be white before I began painting whatever design I was going to paint onto this panel. I could come in with some white paint and begin spraying over all of this blue. And what you're going to see is it will get really white relatively quickly in this area right here that is already white. But the rest of the panel is going to be a little bit darker because of the underlying blue. One of the downsides with water-based paint is they are transparent by nature. They don't have the same covering capacity as, say, a solvent-based paint system when you're actually using the paint colors. Eventually, it would cover to a nice uniform white color, but it's going to take you a lot of coats to get it there because we have different values of color on this panel. That's where sealers come in. We could take the Auto Born sealer white and spray probably two, maybe three coats at the most and get complete coverage and an even white color. The difference between the Autoborn sealers and the rest of the water-based Createx paints is the Autoborn sealers are designed as a sealer. They have a lot better covering capacity compared to the paints themselves. So that's why we would use a sealer. In the case of a blank automotive license plate or even a tumbler, if you're already working on a uniform colored surface, there's really no need for a sealer. You can buy blank license plates that are made out of either aluminum or stainless steel. The ones that I use are actually made out of aluminum and they are powder coated white. As far as tumblers are concerned, I'm pretty sure all of those are going to be stainless steel. If you're going to paint directly over stainless steel, the process is going to be a little bit different, and I'm not going to cover that in this particular video. But you can also buy tumblers that come powder coated. I actually ordered a set of four of these prior to this video. Unfortunately, they didn't make it here in time for me to do anything with them in this particular video. So I'll do something with those in a future video down the line. The license plates that I use you can get at Coast Airbrush. These are powder coated white, as I said. I'll leave a link in the description below where you can get these. I'll also leave a link to the tumblers that I actually ordered. Powder coat is an extremely good surface to do your custom paint projects on. It has really good adhesion. It's extremely durable stuff as long as you prep the surface accordingly first. You can probably see, hopefully in this video, powder coat's a relatively glossy surface. If you just start painting your masterpiece onto this glossy surface as it is, you're not going to have very good adhesion and it's not going to last very long. So the first thing we want to do is make sure the surface is super clean. To do that, I'm going to use some 4012 reducer and a blue shop towel. Got two shop towels. One will be used to dry the product off. I'm just going to put a little bit of 4012 reducer onto a blue shop towel, and then I'm going to wipe the surface down. All I'm doing here is removing any contaminants that might be on the surface. If you don't do this step before you start scuffing the surface, when you start scuffing the surface, you can actually rub those contaminants into the panel and they will remain there, which can cause you problems down the road. Then I'm going to take a dry paper towel and just wipe off any residual reducer from the panel. So now we have a clean surface to begin working on. Next step is to take a red Scotch-Brite pad, and you can use these over and over. You can tell, hopefully, this one's been used quite a bit. Now all I'm going to do is scuff the surface. The only thing I'm trying to do at this point is to remove the gloss. I'm not putting a lot of pressure onto the surface or anything. I'm just rubbing the surface down, and I'll do that until all of that gloss, shiny, has gone away and I've got a nice uniform dull surface. The process on the tumblers would be exactly the same as this, with one exception. On the tumblers, if you look back at the photo I just showed you a minute ago, you've still got a stainless steel lip around the top and the bottom edge of the tumbler. I would mask those off before you begin scuffing the surface. That looks pretty good. So the next step is to clean the surface one more time. I'm going to use the same paper towel that I used a minute ago, but I'm going to use a different side to just make sure this is clean after we scuff the surface. Same thing with the dry paper towel, just to move any residual reducer on the panel. And at this point, this panel is ready to begin painting on. Again, because we have a uniform white powder coat finish to begin our artwork on, we don't need a sealer. One thing I should have mentioned in that last segment that I didn't think about until after I pulled this down and looked at it, is it's always a good idea to check the surface that you're scuffing from different angles under good lighting, just to make sure that you didn't miss any areas. After pulling this down and looking at it, I can see a few little areas that are still glossy. So before I actually put any paint onto this tag blank, I will need to touch up a few little areas with that Scotch-Brite pad. I didn't spend a lot of time on this because it was simply to show you guys the process in order to get these ready for paint. So keep that in mind. Now on to the second part of Tommy's question, which is, do you need a sealer after you finished your artwork? And the answer is yes, but not in the same sense as the sealer that we use as the underlying color or the underlying layer for our paint. A sealer in the end is a clear coat, something to protect your actual artwork. When it comes to general artwork, there's a lot of choices that you can use as far as clear coats are concerned in order to protect your artwork. It's not as big of a deal if it's just something that's going to hang on a wall indoors somewhere. When you're talking about things that are going to be outside, exposed to all of the elements and other abuse, then you really need to look at a catalyzed automotive urethane clear coat. In the case of a tag blank, that's extremely important because more than likely this will be mounted to a vehicle at some point, and it's going to be exposed to not only the elements but other abuse that you see on the road, whether it's pebbles being thrown up or other objects. So for the ultimate in durability and protection, you want to use a two-part catalyzed automotive urethane clear. I would say the same thing goes in the case of the tumblers. For the ultimate in durability, you would want to use a catalyzed urethane clear coat because the tumblers are going to see abuse from the user just using them on a daily basis, from dropping them to being run through the dishwasher. There's a number of things that can tear up your paint job relatively quickly if you don't have a good barrier of protection to protect all your work. When it comes to spraying a catalyzed automotive urethane clear coat, if you look back at all of my other videos, I have never really talked about spraying 2K clears. And that's for a very specific reason. It's bad enough for our health to be breathing in or inhaling atomized paint that's floating around in the air from general airbrushing. I don't generally wear a mask when I'm making these videos because I have to explain what I'm doing to you guys because I do tutorials. 2K automotive clears are extremely dangerous. They're a whole nother level compared to just the water-based or waterborne paints that I normally spray. That's the reason that I've never really covered those in a video, and I probably never will. It's for safety issues. Do some research. If you're going to do this on your own, it can be done even in a garage setting. At minimum, you need very good ventilation. You don't want to be spraying a catalyzed automotive urethane clear anywhere around an open flame. So if you have your furnaces in the garage or your water heater in the garage, I would say that's not a good idea. At minimum, you want good ventilation around no open flames, you want a respirator, and you want all of your exposed skin to be covered. Isocyanates are dangerous. Do some research. Look it up for yourself, and you make the decision on whether that's something you want to venture into or not. You can always farm that out to a body shop that's local to you. A lot of times they will throw in little art projects or projects that you bring to them while they're clearing another vehicle that they're already repairing. So they've already got clear mixed up, and they will generally not charge you an arm and a leg for that service. But again, all that's up to you. Just out of safety, please do some research before you start venturing into that realm when it comes to your own projects. I hope you guys have got something out of this. If you did, remember to like, subscribe, and share. Once again, I will leave links in the description below to everything that I've used in this video. If you have questions, please let me know in the comments. I'm Trevor with Wicked Art Studio, and I'll see you guys next time.